questo presidio.
Did I frighten you?
Just a little.
I'm sorry. I saw your gear there, so I knew you weren't far off. Let me give you some advice. Don't go down there anymore.
Why not?
My grandfather told me when I was a lad, the dead like to be left alone. They're not very hospitable.
I didn't think policemen were superstitious.
Perhaps in London they aren't, but in a village like ours, good day, miss.
Bye.
I know where we can go.
It's all right, Stan.
Yes, of course it is. It even has a camp bed.
Oh, what a funny smell. I don't think I like it.
It's an airtight room. They use it for storing sails or something. Not bad, is it? Belongs to the chap who runs the boathouse. Only comes here from time to time. Nobody will disturb us here.
No, I don't like it.
Come on, Maureen. Don't be silly, huh?
There aren't any windows, Stan.
All the better. Anyway, it's air-conditioned. You need this to run away. Come on, give us a kiss now. Locked? Look, I'll find you the key. Hey, did you take it?
No.
The key's disappeared. Can't have walked off by itself. It must be here somewhere.
The grill's broken. The air conditioning is not working. Please find the key. I'm frightened, Stan.
Somebody let us out of here! Please, help us!
Stan. Look.
God, somebody wants to kill us.
No, wait a minute. I must go and check on Maureen. She should be asleep.
Trying to reach you. I'm a friend. You can trust me. Speak to me, my friend.
not a sign of Maureen. We searched all night. Stan has disappeared too.
They've run off together.
Let's hope so, Mrs. Grayson. Let's hope they went off together.
Welcome strangers to your village.
Oh, sir. Only when they exceed the speed limit.
I understand. It was you people who asked me down here. I'm Gawley. Inspector Gawley from Scotland Yard.
Sergeant Wilson, sir. The police station's over there. I was the one who phoned the yard asking for help. These two young people have disappeared, and I really don't know if they haven't just eloped.
Could have been worse. Could have been a case of chicken rustling.
She's not a local girl, sir. She's an American who's come here to take some photographs of the ruins.
I'd like to see them.
The ruins, sir?
The photographs.
Excuse me, sir. Now, about the fine, will you pay it now, or shall I send it to Scotland Yard?
It wasn't the first time I've kept an eye on him. But last night, there he was at the cemetery. You actually heard him talking to the dead?
Well, I couldn't actually hear him. But I could see what he was doing.
God knows what you're capable of seeing when you've had a few.
But I tell you, I did. I saw him. He's got this tape. Tape recorder.
I'd like to meet this man.
He's called Miles.
Madam, he's a queer one. Is Miles, I'm telling you. A bit mad, I'd say. You'd do well to keep away from him.
Yes. I lost it. What do you want to know?
Nothing.
Nothing? Why did you bring it back? You aren't from the village?
No.
I suppose they told you a lot of nonsense about Robert Miles.
Well, they say you communicate with the dead.
Scarcely unusual. Any medium does that.
Then why do you do it secretly? What are you afraid of?
Because of the stupidity of these people. Their ignorance makes me behave like a bloody grave robber. Perhaps we've all possibilities within ourselves we are not aware of. Powers we ourselves don't understand.
Maybe we don't want to, because we're terrified.
I have such powers, and I'm not terrified. You see, death is not the end of everything. Just the beginning of a new journey. I want to speak with them to find out.
What will you do once you do find out?
I'm not sure. I know the power of the senses. What it means to see, to hear, touch. Must my mind be limited to that? Can it not reach out for something else?
But there are limits, barriers.
Perhaps not. We set up those barriers in self-defense.
You frighten me.
I do. Oh, I'd be very disappointed if I thought you were superstitious.
No. I'm just afraid you won't know when to stop.
You're a lovely girl, Jill. Your hands are gentle and soft. Your eyes clear. I like to look into them. When I speak to you, you can't move away. I could command you to do anything, and you would act without being aware. Your will incapable. Obeying only my mind.
Why on earth do you keep him?
We need each other. Oh, don't try to understand. We are bound together by hatred. He wants to kill me.
But he's only a cat.
A cat that sooner or later will kill me. And there's nothing I can do to prevent it.
There goes one of the better customers. Thank you.
is it?
Inspector Gawley, I need your help. Good morning. Look, I'm sorry to drag you out of bed like this, but I'm afraid it's pretty important.
What's happened?
There's been an accident. I understand that you're the only photographer this village has to offer. I need some photographs before I can move the body.
Who is it?
He was unbelievably drunk.
Is this stretcher parked outside? Do I have him coming?
He must have got lost in the dark up there and then fallen.
What do you want now?
I need your help. You're the only person who can help me find my daughter.
I can't help you.
Miles, please. I'll come back to you. If you want, I'll do anything.
That was so long ago. We can't go back in time. Have you an object belonging to Maureen? Open the door. Key. You must find the key. Find the key. The top is wet. The top is wet. Help me, please. Please, 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 help me!
I think I know. I know where she is.
Thank you. I always kept the key there. I thought it was a secret. Only me and Stan knew about it.
We'll have to try and break the door down. Okay, Sergeant. Try not to make too much mess, will you?
The tarpaulin.
The current's been cut off. Yeah. That's it. Where'd you find it?
Sealed.
Come along, madam. No point staying here.
The rats must have smelled the bodies and eaten a hole in the floor.
The man out by the water. Stop my boat.
Okay, one over here. One over there while you're at it. Mr. Miles. Thank you for coming. Have you seen this place before?
I've seen it, so to speak. But I've not been here, if that's what you mean.
Oh, yes, of course. You're supposed to have supernatural powers.
You don't seem very convinced.
Mr. Myers, a policeman, likes to have more practical, realistic evidence.
You suspect me? Oh, say so frankly if you do.
Mr. Myers, I would suspect you, if I thought you were small enough to pass through that grill.
I don't understand.
The lab tells us that the door was locked from the inside. So they must have locked themselves in before turning off the ventilator. This grill was the only way anyone could leave with the key without unlocking that door.
Suicide, then.
We didn't find the key inside. We found it outside. Sitting on one of the boats. On a tarpaulin.
Oh, my God.
speaking. Jill, yes, of course I remember you. What photographs? Yes, of course. Whenever you wish. Well, now, if you like. Fine. Fine, I'll wait for you here. For you, it's a theory. For me, it's a certainty.
But they'll think we're crazy if we say it's a cat.
But we're not crazy. In the case of the two kids, it was the cat also.
Do you mean Maureen and Stan?
Yes. He brought the key through the air conditioning conduit.
That's absurd. He would have to have thought it out. You can't seriously think that.
If he was human, we'd hang him.
But he's only a cat. What you're saying isn't possible.
You brought these photographs.
Oh,
Two deaths in the same family. The plot thickens, Sergeant.
What do you mean?
The daughter's death was an accident, which we haven't managed to explain. Don't forget that business about the key and how it managed to turn up outside on the boat. And then there was that drunk, Ferguson, who turned himself into a shish kebab.
Thought it was Foreman, too.
Huh? Who's he?
Before you arrived. He was killed in a road accident on a perfectly straight, dry road. Drove into a parked car at full speed.
An epidemic of accidents, and all of them pretty weird. Not bad. For a beginner.
I'm not exactly a beginner. I happen to make my living as a photographer.
Yes, I know. What I mean is, I hope you're a beginner at photographing corpses.
Oh, yes, I am. This is my very first time.
Inspector, the autopsy reports have arrived. The ones on those two kids.
Looks like, hair.
Cat's fur, to be precise. Black cat's fur.
Did you find it in the air conditioner?
Yes, miss. That's exactly where it was.
What do you know about this?
Look. That's funny. I must have left them at home.
Did you hear anything special then?
Yeah, well, I heard Ferguson scream when he fell.
That's all?
Well, then he got spiked, didn't he?
Well, did you hear a fight or a quarrel?
Oh, there's no one to quarrel with, no. No one comes in here during the night. It's only me. Oh, and Violet and a couple of cats.
I thought,
What have you thought?
No, nothing. Thanks very much. You've been a great help. I'm sorry, Jill. Getting you out of bed is becoming a habit. Were you asleep?
Not yet. Come in. What's the matter? You haven't gotten me out of bed just to look at me.
Well, I think it's a good idea.
Well, I hope you've got a better one.
Better, but not so good. No, I need some more information on your theories about cats.
Not cats. One cat.
All right, one cat. Or rather, a killer cat. Would this cat have anything to do with Mr. Miles? Or am I mistaken?
It might not be.
You know Mr. Miles, then?
Everybody knows him.
And you know what the people in the village say about him?
I might know more than that. So after everything I've told you, you still don't believe in the supernatural?
You mean witchcraft? No. Look, a cat is still a cat. A cat doesn't come through a grill, blow a fuse and steal a key. It can't turn off an air ventilator. And how does a cat, Jill, set fire to Mrs. Grayson's house, hmm?
What if the cat's only an instrument? What if his mind's being dominated by another mind? By a human mind?
No, no, it's mad, Joe. Completely mad.
I know it's mad. But it's the only way we can explain all those crimes.
Do you honestly expect me to go down to London and tell them all this? Huh. No, my boss, Larry Flynn, would have to say. I haven't been off the bottle since I've been down here.
Maybe you wouldn't say that if you drank a little bit less.
Well, every man to his own folly.
I'm sure you're a better person than you want me to believe.
Well, not if you knew what I was thinking.
That's not hard to imagine.
He has cheated death itself.
Thank you. No! I didn't want that! It shouldn't have happened!
How many times do I have to tell you? If he wasn't drunk, he was trying to get himself killed. There was no way I could avoid him. He suddenly lurched towards my car.
May I ask you something? Did he act as if he were being commanded?
Commanded?
Excuse me. You said before that his movements were like those of a robot.
Yes, like a robot.
And was there a cat there?
A cat?
Yes, a black cat on the sidewalk. Before he ran out in front of your
car. Miss Travers, I really can't think why we should be worrying about a cat.
Please try and remember. It's actually very important.
A black cat. It was rather dark, you know.
Yes. Oh, yes. Right, sir. Inspector Flynn has already left London. He should be here in an hour or so.
You knew. You should have stopped him.
Maybe you're right. Come with me. Buried him here.
What about last night?
He's dead, I tell you. Nothing more can happen.
And what about Inspector Goarly?
An accident. Nothing more than an accident. Simply decided to live. I didn't succeed in killing him.
He's responsible for all those deaths.
I know.
But he couldn't have acted alone.
Cats take orders from no one.
Not normal orders. But you yourself said the human mind has possibilities we're unaware of. You're the killer, Miles. You have extraordinary powers. The cat was only an instrument, just one of your victims. You entered his mind and took control of his will. You forced him to obey you. You forced him to kill.
No. I haven't wanted to kill. The beast just understood my suppressed hatred. And people's failure to understand. The frustration of the solitude I was forced into. They forced me to obey the evil side of my nature. That evil that exists in all of us. When I understood that, I decided to kill him, to suppress the evil.
But he's still alive.
Yes, he's still alive. He has beaten me. He's stronger than me now. He has destroyed my will. He is the evil one. He doesn't have to hide in the shadows. Now, I do whatever he wants. It's he who dominates me now.
she's not home. Plus, no one's seen her around the village.
Looks like she's flown the coop.
I thought she was such a tidy girl.
Strange she should leave without a word.
Sheer terror, I imagine. She believed that mad story she told us. These must be some of the photographs she was working on. The ruins is why she came here in the first place, sir.
And yet she left them behind.
Look, sir, there are hundreds of them.
You ask me, she wasn't running away. She wouldn't have left valuable work like this behind. Are you mad, Gawler?
Yes, well, that's why I preferred you to think that I was drunk.
Are you sure you're not now?
Yep. Help me get dressed.
But, sir, you're in no condition to...
Oh, belt up. She's looking for a pussycat. She's got problems.
Good evening, Mr. Miles. Inspector Flynn would like to have a few words with you.
Of course.
Good evening.
Good evening.
And Inspector Gawler. We've met before, remember.
But you've been hurt.
Only hurt, Mr. Miles.
We'd like to know whether Miss Jill Travers has been here today.
Oh, Jill. Oh, yes, she has been here today to say goodbye. She decided to return to London.
We doubt that. We think she came here looking for something.
That is?
To see if your cat is still alive.
Don't be silly. Why would Jill be interested in a cat?
Not a cat. Your cat.
My cat is dead, Inspector.
You don't mind if we take a look around, do you?
You are not looking for a cat. You're looking for Jill. She's not here. Look where you choose.
Excuse us.
No luck. Hated me. And now he has won.